We dramatically asked the average tall man in the street to name this film.
We're big, well, we're small cog in the wheel at the Edinburgh Film Festival, but we're massive in Belford. Big in Belford.
Get on the train, Saint. Getting really annoyed now. Get on the train. There we go.
Bloody noise.
So we're on the wrong train. Well, we're getting off, we're getting the right train.
Right. And for those of you deaf, we didn't say night train.
Not night train, wrong train.
That explains why we were no coach train.
Right. And that lady, thank that lady, finding your wallet.
Yeah, great. Now I know why there was no coach, Jay. We're on the wrong train.
We're on the wrong train, and you lost your wallet on the train, yeah.
Yeah.
But a nice lady brought it back.
Yeah.
Act of kindness, that, wasn't it? Really, that's what it's all about with the life, isn't it?
And at Bradford Movie Maker.
And at Bradford Movie Maker.
Most of the time.
Right.
Catch
you falling. Here's our train at Darlington. At Darlington.
Oh, it's having the stairs.
All right, yeah. C, G, H, J, there's no I. We're just missing it. Hang on, I'll come back down. Oh, no, no. That's Alma Bay. Almouth Bay.
Oh my god.
We're here now.
I'm just going to Jen's door triple.
Well, is it, we're here now, we're here now.
Okay. Oh, we're early. That's it. Yeah, that'll be worse, wouldn't it?
There's a toilet on the other side.
Cheers, thank you. Yeah, cheers.
Then Joe.
Here we all are.
Almouth.
Almouth.
Yeah, next stop, Scotland. Well, sort of.
Oh, yeah.
You've got Berwick upon Tweed, then. Which
well, my
used
father's
to be Scottish.
Family were all from Sunderland.
Yep. Oh,
so
okay.
I know the North East. It was really funny when we won the World Cup.
Yeah.
My dad was a communist. I mean, my aunt, his aunt was the deputy mayor of Sunderland, and at home I've got six tumblers. Specially made for the six teams that played at Roker.
Oh, right.
Signed by the presidents, football presidents of each country. Took them on a road show and they just said, can't value them.
Priceless, yeah, yeah, priceless.
Well, they only made 50 sets. And, wow. Oh, and I've got the menu signed by the president.
Really? In the opening scenes of the new Indiana Jones film.
Oh, yeah.
They filmed... have you seen it, the new Indiana Jones?
No.
Okay, so at the beginning, there's a sort of flashback scene where they're in the Second World War. The Nazis are in some old French castle.
Right.
And they've got all of these paintings and all this stuff they've nicked.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And the Nazis are trying to... escape with all their loot,
yeah,
while they're being bombed by the Americans, and Indiana Jones turns up in the middle of all of this.
Yeah.
And all those opening scenes in the so-called French castle were filmed here,
right,
in the main hall,
right,
at Bamburgh.
Oh, what?
I'm not mad on trike, but apart from that...
Apart from that, you'll have anything.
Yeah. Not much, yeah. I am the opposite.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
50s.
I think we're on the old A1, Joe. There's a coaching house over there. And this is where we're talking tonight, Bellevue.
I fashion in Belford. Well groomed. Winnie the Pooh. Deliveroo. Cake anyone? I was missing Dave already. I wonder what today's soup is. Ah, beef and parsley soup tomorrow.
Two people waiting for at the back, but we'll start without them. Yeah, where's Dave?
And then speak. I like your t-shirt, that's where you went, wasn't it? It's a wonderful thing to be able to talk to people about the film, people that either made the film or are involved in making the films. You can ask the horse's mouth, as it were.
Well, at least he's the mouth.
Yeah. Phil's not here, by the way. So
Phil has now got more care as Dewey, not only his brother, but his mother's poorly. So he asked me to fill him. The first time we showed this film in Sheffield, it won the audience award out of 68 films. So we knew it was going to do something. Then we went to Edinburgh Festival, Bloomsbury, all over. But what I'd like to say, the welcome I've got off Claire, we'd rather be big in Belford. Enjoy the film.
Thank you.
thank you. I've got to point out one thing before you ask questions. A lot of people think we acted that. It's all up the, on the hoof. Right, who's got the first question?
Can I ask a couple?
Yeah, of course you can.
Firstly, thanks ever so much. It's just, I've watched it three times now and it's just genius. And I think everybody in the room feels the same. So, yeah.
A lot of that's down to Kim and Margaret as well.
Yeah.
Nine hours of footage, that was.
Wow.
A lot more than 9 hours.
They cut all mine out, no, I'm joking.
This is a question for you, Joe. You were telling me earlier, because I asked the question, like, how on earth did that happen? How did Kim Hopkins find you and have the crazy idea to make a film about you? And I asked this question, and Joe, apparently it's all Joe's fault.
No, it's my fault, yeah. I'm sorry about that. I was doing poetry at one time, and I used to be a kind of slam poet, and I used to go around to Bristol and that. So I put my poetry online, and she found it, and she thought it was interesting. Thinking of a northern guy like me doing poetry like that, and then she says, oh, I see you make films also, and I went, yeah, I do make films. And so she saw some of the films. Can I say how many? Well, about 250 now, if you want to have a look. And she said, oh, she liked them, so can I come to your club? I went, yeah, anytime you want. I was surprised that she wanted to come. She met with Phil, the guy was sweary Phil, but, and she would find us fascinating, and that was it. It's a story that she carried on from there.
And do you know, maybe I should ask Margarita, her producer, this, but do you know whether she already had the money to make the film, or she just did it off her own back?
She thought she had a good idea, and she thought, let's go for this. So, it wasn't until we did Harry on the horse, and he fell off the horse, and he was in the field, that anybody from Met Films and all the people that supported us, and all the, you know, lists and lists, came with funding, yeah. Go on.
I think it was the bit with Joe saying in the canteen, well, have you ever ridden a horse? No. And it was quite a big horse.
Yeah, it looks like a big horse. Yeah.
But that lady was just, it's amazing how you can network. If you try, it was just a phone call. Do you want to be in a film? Yeah, okay.
I'd imagine you're quite persuasive, Dave.
I am, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, no, not so much persuasive, but I'm not bothered who I ask.
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
I think it's been a caterer for 40 years. You think on the fly, things crop up and you solve them. Yeah. Oh, I like doing it. I like networking.
Yeah.
Anybody got a question?
Or comment or anything, really?
Just think about I'm just fascinated by the ideas that the guys come up with for the films that they do. Is it born out of a conversation that you have with each other?
Born in a old pub near the club called Jacobs, well after the meetings, because the meetings when we're trying to discuss things, I wasn't joking about the Zoom. It's not like you chair a meeting and everybody thought it's like a Zoom. So we do it in the pub.
Why didn't we see any of that in the film?
Because we hadn't really started using that pub, had we, at the time, or not much.
Well, one of the truths being is that we got very silly in the pub and it was very difficult to edit.
You mean drunk?
No, not mad. I have to drive home along.
Well, some of us were a little bit silly when she tried to film in the pub. And
you mean you? No, but I'm being serious now. At every event I've said, well, this is the best one we've ever had this week, but this is the nicest one we've had, without a doubt.
People are very friendly.
Come on, Mark, I'm sure you can think of something sarcastic. No?
How's your membership going now?
Well, we had 15, and we've now got 20-something. But it's helped, and we've got a few younger members. We've got a South Asian male young member, a Indian lady member. We've also, every year the Sikhs in Bradford march between the temples, and I did it as part of a degree in 2003. So I said, well, why don't we all film it? So we did a leg each and things like that. But it's hard to get things done sometimes. I mean, even though I presented this community with the work I did in 2003, it took us 9 months to say, okay.
Yeah. I know, they don't make decisions quickly.
The only way I got round it, I set up a pretend interview, knowing that all the committee would suss
there.
Us out and vice versa. So while they were doing the interview, I went down for a free meal.
Can I just say that online now, we've got well over 1,700 members online via Facebook and social media systems. So, yeah.
That's brilliant.
Which is...
And before this film, we had 42 members. We've now got one off 1,700. You're all more than welcome to join us. It's free.
And donate.
But we didn't get paid to do it.
No, that's obvious. But what one thing I really want to know is, how's Colin doing? Because
he's a bit frail, but he's okay.
He's
fell
so
again.
Oh,
he fell, we were having his birthday in April, and he fell the week before. He's a bit fragile, but he's tough.
He's amazing.
Oh, yeah.
He?
I mean, yeah. That
what
bit. I hadn't seen that bit in the garden to wish. I'm going. The reason there were fireworks and we couldn't get an ambulance, that was bonfire night and it's mentally in Bradford.
Yeah, of course, yes.
Do you know if it's had an impact on the other film clubs in Yorkshire?
Well,
that
I think it. No, we haven't heard anything. The problem is, we're doing okay, but one of our nearest clubs have got 3 members. But we're lucky we've got some young ones who are very interested, quite prepared to be vocal and suggest things. But one of the problems is, in all these sort of clubs, a quarter do the work and the rest just appear when they have to. But there's a better vibe, shall we say, than there was.
That's what fascinated me, that you're all coming with your own ideas for your films and things, but somehow you're managing to work as a group to get things made.
Yeah, well, it's quite rare we've had big group films like The Saint March. But again, no wages, as you said. At the end of it, we all 20 of us go to the best place in Bradford for a curry. The average.
Yes, that's right, it's a good one.
Well, Andrew, the secretary and the treasurer, but I'd say he's the guy that holds the club together, because he does all the work.
Yeah.
And when anything goes wrong, they're all at him.
Yeah.
But they never say thank you. We're not rich now, but we're safe. And I must give a shout out for the landlord, Mr. Hussain. He's just the nicest guy on the planet. We got him 2 tickets to the sort of official premiere at Bradford at the Major Museum. And it was like, oh, thanks, guys. I mean, we honestly didn't pay the rent, but, and the thing is, the premises now, they've done up. If he wasn't the guy he was, they could say go. And what a conference centre.
Yeah.
40-seat cinema, green screen. You could bling the kitchen up a bit, but that's all it is.
I mean, what we've got is a really diverse group as well. We've got young people as well as older people, which is more than a lot of other clubs have got. They've all gone aged and they've never been able to diversify it or anything like that. I don't know why. It just happens to be that we're in a club and we just happen to be the lucky one that we can diversify. We've got different people coming in and it's quite a different vibe. You know, it's like a very... The student vibe at some points, very very much so that the media students from the University of Bradford come along and see us. So we're quite good that. We're quite lucky that way, really.
And the other thing, because the film, like I said, I'm not backward at coming forward. We'd probably get connections with, like we're doing archiving, and I just email the National Archive at Kew, end up with 2 Zoom meetings with the head guy. Well, that probably wouldn't have happened before the film.
Well,
I've got a little present for you.
Yeah, this is for the community cinema. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, are you good at getting bubble wrap off, Claire?
Yeah, we good. We'll save this, we'll take it to the coffee shop.
And the person with the best question gets to pop all the bubbles.
Oh, here we go. What's it say? Oh. Oh, that is so nice.
Honorary membership of our club. secretary, and there's very few of those. Two of them are Commode and Mayo, who begged the film up on the club.
Yeah,
our two seat members, honorary members.
So
there's
boring.
Only about a dozen in existence.
Thank you.
And nobody on our tour has had one, I assure you.
Oh,
you can keep the bubble wrap.
Yeah, yeah.
Is there anything else you
want to
say, Joe?
Me? No, I'm just saying, thank you very much. I love these little venues that we go to. 300 people, popped out like in Sheffield.
Where?
A standing ovation, by the way. Well, they came in and not one seat was spare, and we did three in a row, and we're just giving question Q&A's and all different questions, but every day, you know, it were like, you know, people were crowded and you couldn't get enough people in. So I was shocked.
What Kim Hopkins, the director's next film is?
Oh God!
Just tell them, because it's quite interesting. In like
the band that brought you Agadoo.
Well, is it like a
Butlins
sort of thing?
Well, yeah.
Well, like Agadoo is the guys from Black Lace. You sing Agadoo, Push the Pineapples, and he wrote a book called Push Pineapples with the lead singer. And it used to be like an eight-piece band, and now it's gone down to three people and maybe even two now. We might even get an opportunity at the club to make a film with them. That keep that on the rats. You only know it here. So it may or may not come off, but if it does, we may be doing the next video thing.
So Kim's making a film about these...
About the band,
yeah.
And the people who are in the north of England.
And goes to these regular weekends.
Yeah. And go to the regular weekends. Yeah. Working people. She's into working people. So.
Yeah.
So if you're working class, you know, unlike what I am, you'll be in there. So, you know, if you want to go to an Agadoo weekend, go down there, you'll be filmed.
Yeah. But I think Kim's filmmaking is... She gets the soul. I mean, she's done a fantastic one on people leaving Cuba. She did a documentary with Billy Bragg in an American band called Wilco on Woody Guthrie.
Yeah.
So she only does things she really wants to do.
The film has been abroad to Canada and...
It's been to Canada three times, America twice. It won Best Documentary in Santa Barbara, which is equal to the Oscar-winning film... But for documentaries in Santa Barbara, so it's won that kind of accolade.
Did it win the audience award, did you say?
We won the prize at Sheffield. In Bradford it went, that's all right.
Thanks for coming.
It's good.
Yeah,
it's
come
good.
Again.
Thank you.
I think
that's it then. Should we go down the pub?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mine's a blonde.
I know, I should have ended the film here, but...
Old Codry, sitting down.
It's Joe and Dave, bigging it up in Belford.
The Belford Village Trail. The trail from Dr. MacDonald's Memorial Bench, right next to the Market Cross. Just across the way, MacDonald's Logistics, for all your logistical needs. The trail took us back to the West Street Well, used until the 1920s, when Belford got plumbed in taps. The smallest museum in the North East. Nice clock. The large auctioneer stick. Used in the auctioneer's box, the farmer's stand, and just look.
Some nice pottery in the museum.
Iridescent upside down blue pot with awls in the lid. Houses around Belford that got taps in the 1920s. A sports medal for cricket. items from the demolished Belford Bank. You have a guess what these are for. That's right, the McDonald's Doctor instruments. We read about the history of the bluebell, the local alltale. Notable residents of Belford. Flying the Sopwith shuttle 1.5 inch. The First World War flying ace, Geoffrey Hornblower Cock. Jeff to his friends. Next time we visit, we'll go to Wooler and the Castle Daisy Buller. Tired, we are homeward bound. Well, if a train ever stops.